What's up, everybody? Today we're going to talk about cue points. Yes, the infamous, most annoying thing to do when it comes to turntablism, which is setting cue points with stickers. I will tell you something, doesn't matter how long you've been doing this, you will never master it. It takes a lot of time and patience to set a cue point. I'm humbling myself when I say that. So you take a sticker right here, yard sale sticker, and you want to bend it forward a little bit. And you want the needle to rest right there in the middle of it. So you want to push it right there to where the needle is gonna catch right on the edge, but in the middle. Not over here, not over here, right at the top. So let's give it a shot. I'm not gonna hit start, I'm gonna load it in. Alright, there it is. Alright, so let's go for it. So just gonna slide it right under there. But just without touching the needle. And center it out. Alright, and then let go. Alright. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna hit this here. I'm gonna take my razor and I'm gonna lift this up, okay? So I can work with it in case I don't have it. If I didn't get it right on the spot, now I can move this sticker, I can pull back on it or move it forward, whichever way I want. Okay, so I missed it by one groove. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull back a little bit on it. Just a little bit. All right, and now I'm going to try it again. See what happened? I went too far back. That's the annoying part about this. So I'm just going to go back up a little bit. Obviously, after I get done with this, you would wipe your record because you're going to put fingerprints all over it. But that's not really a concern right now. Alright, so I got to move it back a little bit. It's tricky, I'm telling you. Oh, I think I got it. And the point is for the needle, slide right up against it. At the top of the curve, you load it right at the top of the curve where it slides into the groove. So watch. Looks like I got it. Look, yep. So now I can close her down and she's stuck and that, and she's there to stay. And that's the beauty of cue points, is that once you get it, it's done with. So there it is. You see how it is on the money shot? And then look, you just take it like this and then. I'll show you a record. Here's some interesting cue points right here. One right there, one little one right there. That one took me a while. And then one right there, one right there. These take time, but what's great is that I don't even need headphones. I can just drop the needle right there, boom. So I have my scratch ready, my cue point. So it's for quick mixing and for scratching. Plus the sticker works as a tracker. It tells you where the cut is. So when you're cutting the fader out, you know where to bring the record back. You know, kind of loop it, so for some constructive cutting and sampling stuff. See? You know, most people think it's a cardinal sin to put stickers on records, but you know, that's their deal. I'm not really concerned. I'm about getting to my cue points and my spots when I need to, as soon as possible. I don't want to miss my timing. That's really important when you're mixing. So now I've got two cue points on this record.
Trust me, I'm as live as it gets.